Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Ravi Pitawala, pre-sales consultant for Barracuda at Redington. And today's I'm going to give you the webinar for the email threat scanner. I'll show you the demo for that product, as well as I'm going to talk about the latest threat on the email. So let's get started. So as we know that most of the breaches that we have seen, it started with the email. As you can see on the screen, 93% of the email. The email breaches is the main reason of the threats or breaches that occurred during the 2018. That's the report from Verizon. And as we are in a current situation, most of the organization employee working from home, maybe around 50%, if not less and more. And it's going to be the new normal that those who doesn't have any work or they can work from the home, they are still going to be working from home. And in that situation, email remains the key communication component for most of the organization. And in today's world, it is more important than ever to secure the emails of the organization. So next slide, I will talk about the research that Barracuda has conducted in the face of COVID-19. What are the pattern that we have seen? So what we have seen is during this time when this pandemic was just about to start during the March, we have seen that coronavirus domain registration was on the rise. And the main reason remains that they can use that email of that domain to send a specific phishing email or a fake email to the any company to launch an attack or to get the control of that organization. Not only that, apart from domain, what we have seen is the phishing attack is also increasing during those time. And attackers were very smart. They spend the time on weekdays more, not on the weekend, so that they can target the remote worker very easily. So there is the graph that we have seen. You can see the spike that is during the weekdays, and during the weekend there wasn't many attack. And these are very carefully time attacked, and while malicious email can arrive any day of the week, spear phishing attack peak was between the Tuesday to Thursday, within 1 to 5 email bills sent on Tuesday. This is the pattern that we have seen during this time. And given the fact that business are the typical targets, it's not surprising that weekend days make up the lowest percentage of the attack. That's what we have seen. And not only that, what we have gathered the information is that there is a toolkit available to launch and this kind of phishing email attacks or the spear phishing email attacks, and it's available on the dark web. You just need to purchase that, and that's why there is more reason to attack in time, because the kit is available. You can download it, use it. You can trick the user and get into the network of the user. That's how simple it is. And some of the this toolkit provider, they were also providing the support as well. So even if you face an issue during, if when you are launching an attack, you can get the support as well. Same like how you get from the security vendor. And these are the modern threats that we will discuss in little bit in detail, like account takeover, conversation hijacking, business email compromise, brand impersonation. And if you can see that the gray out image is the email gateway. So email gateway is very useful to block the attack of a traditional email like spam, the malware in the email, and zero day attack by integration with the sandbox. But when we talk about the modern day threats, that requires a little bit more precise technique or more advanced technique than what you get in the traditional email security gateway. And you might be familiar about the what technology or the technique that you get in the email security to protect against the specific type of email attack. So let's get started with the account takeover. So as the name suggests, account takeover is nothing but it occurs when fraudster gain access to legitimate user email account, maybe through data breaches that expose the credential, purchasing from the dark web, that's what we discuss, or a phishing scam. And email account takeover can even be more complicated and harmful when it is executed in pursuit of a cross account takeover, that means from one account they can access to another account. In this type of attack, the fraudster gain access to an email or a mobile account. It executes a password change or a one-time password and takes over victim account with their financial institute information to facilitate the transfer of the fund. So that's the main reason the launch attack. It's 99% of time reason being of the money, right? So this is what they do in the account takeover. And there are different techniques of the account email account takeover. So hacking, phishing spears, social engineering, botnet, and traditional stuffing. So these are the different techniques that is used by the hacker to gain access of the account. So let's talk about the hacking. So as we know, there are multiple hacking techniques used by the hacker. The most popular remains the brute force attack, where they develop automated script. They churn through a password combination and hoping to generate a successful login key. That's what the script does. Second is the phishing and spear phishing. So in that, cyber criminal will use email correspondent to trick user into revealing their personal information. That's what they do. They send a phishing email, might be the link in the email which will route them to the specific website where they will have to put the information about their personal identity, and that's how they get the specific information which they want. While this phishing email, it can be automated and easier to spot, spear phishing email are highly targeted and much more deceptive. You can say it's the advanced level of phishing. That's in that they use different technique and target the specific user to get the information that they want. Next is the social engineering. As the name suggests, there are multiple way to contact anyone in the world. The popular social media remains the Twitter, LinkedIn, Facebook, by which they can penetrate into the account, specific organization, but they will have to spend the time. So this kind of attack, it requires a lot of persistence. So again, to get the specific information through this kind of media, hacker will be very patient and persistent. And after that, what they try to do, they get the information like name, location, that's a city or country, phone number, the name of the family member, and anything that will assist in guessing a password. So that's what they do. They gather the information, and then after gathering that information, they will use the combination of this information to get into the account of the specific user. Next is the botnet. So in that, hacker will do nothing but deploy the bot to hack into customer accounts. It can plug in commonly used password and username to perform the high volume rapid attack and take over maximum number of accounts. There are multiple ways by which hacker can get into the network and install the bot. And after that, because this bot deploy from multiple location, it's harder to identify the malicious IP address who is communicating with this bot. So again, for this you require a different kind of technique, but this is also one of the technique to get the account takeover. And lastly, the credential stuffing. As the name suggests, the credential stuffing will use the stolen credential from the leaked website, which is very famous, where just take the example of Amazon or noon.com website, e-commerce website, where you will provide your user information. So that is what the hacker do. The popular website that have been already compromised, they get the username and password from that website, and then they will test it against the different organization in hope of catching a victim who hasn't realized the login information is compromised. That's what they do into the credential stuffing. So these are the different techniques of the account takeover. So what is the goal of account takeover? So again, the main goal remains the phishing campaign. They might want me to damage the reputation of the organization. So account takeover isn't inherently useful to the cyber criminal. What happens after they gain access is where the solution or the is where this serious harm can occur. For example, phishing campaign, some attacker try to use the hacker email account to launch phishing campaign that will go undetected. In credential sell, some attackers steal the credential of the employee and sell them into the black market or the dark web. Further account takeover. Otherwise, use the account to conduct the reconnaissance in order to launch personalized attack. Then the business email compromise, which I will discuss in detail in the later slides, that what happens there. And reputation damage is, of course, the competitor company who just want to damage the reputation of the organization. There are ways that they can also take the help of the hacker and launch an attack using the account takeover, and they might send a bad email to the specific government organization or compliance authority from the organization, and they will fall into the trap of the competitor. Next is the brand impersonation. Again, this is a type of spear phishing attack designed to impersonate well-known companies and commonly used business application are by far the most popular because they are well designed as an entry point to harvest credential and carry out account takeover. So before doing the account takeover, they can get into the account by impersonation attack. So brand impersonation attacks are also used to steal the person personally identifiable information such as credit card, social security number, and so on. And what we have seen is Microsoft and Apple are the most impersonated brand in the spear phishing attack. So is the DocuSign. As we are into this situation, a lot of the thing is going on to the cloud, digital, and lots of companies using DocuSign. So this is again one of the main brand that has been impersonated. So and different companies like Amazon, LinkedIn, American Express. So these are the different companies that we have seen and that been impersonated, and Microsoft remain the most popular among all the hackers because of the use of the Office 365, and that is the main reason that has been the nearly one in the five attacks involves this Microsoft impersonation. And what you have seen in financial institution that the breach that occur the more this brand impersonation remains again one of the top five attack tool for the hacker. And 83% of the spear phishing attack involves this brand impersonation as well. So what happens in the brand impersonation? How do you identify that this is a brand impersonation? So I will just give you one email sample that we have collected from one of the company. And this is again during the COVID situation. As you can see how the brand impersonation works, the scammer use the email to impersonate trusted entity, as we discussed, like Microsoft, Apple. And then they will send a email which is a genuine email. There is nothing harm in it. The only thing it will be there will be one phishing URL into it, or maybe they want to just start the communication with the internal employee of organization. And here you can see the subject is the health advice. And if I just zoom in, you can see the from the email which has come is World Health Organization, and it's no reply at who.org. Now anyone will think that this is the email that has come from WHO, and because everyone wants to follow the compliance and want to be very active in the today's situation, they will of course give attention to this email, and whatever they are asking they might reveal as well. But here this is where the brand impersonation has happened, and who.org is again is not as authorized domain for World Health Organization. If you just Google it right now, you will find what is the actual domain of the WHO. It's not .org. So this is where the brand impersonation has occurred. and male is spoofed and offer a phishing site that is already there in the email that has the information about the COVID-19. And once you click on that, it will ask you about the personal information, and then hacker gets whatever it's want. So just search on the Google in the meantime, what is the actual domain of the WHO? So you'll get the information. Next is the business email compromise. As the name suggests, in business email compromise, it's a type of a scam targeting company who conduct a wire transfer and have a supplier abroad. So what happens, they can actually manipulate the account number and get the money into their own account. So here you can see in the diagram, employee account, email account is compromised by cyber criminal. So corporate or publicly available email account of top executive or the high level employee related to financial department or involved with the wire transfer payment, they are either spoofed or compromised to different attack that we have already discussed. Again, they can use a different technique like keylogger, phishing attack to do the fraudulent transfer, result in hundreds of thousands of dollars in losses. This is again, it is formally dubbed as man in the middle email scam. So business email compromise attack rely heavily on social engineering techniques to trick unsuspecting employee and executive. Often they impersonate COE or any executive that has the authorized to do the wire transfer. In addition, fraudster also carefully research and closely monitor their potential target victim and their organization. Some of the sample email have subject containing words such as request, payment, transfer, urgent, and so on, based on the research that we have conducted. You might have seen one of the bogey invoice schema, the company where foreign suppliers are often targeted with the tactics wherein attacker pretend to be the supplier requesting fund transfer for the payment to the account owned by the fraudster itself. So this is what they do, and they get the money in the account where they want. So in current situation where not everyone wants to go to the public places, most of the company might go into the situation where they request for the wire transfer through email as well. And in that kind of situation, business email compromise remain one of the key attack tool for the hacker as well. So here you can see one of the email. It's very harmful email. There is nothing wrong in that email. It's very difficult to identify as well. It is from the company of employee of one company to another employee that, are you in office? I need to process a bank transfer. Quickly reply when it's done. And then the signature. But what you've seen here is the domain name is slightly different, but it looks like from the visual it's the same. So this is what they do in the scamming of the business email compromise. If you notice, the domain of the Jane and Michael is totally different, but it looks the same. So this is what happens is business email compromise. Now, apart from the business email compromise, there is an advanced level of attack that is called a conversation hijacking. And to execute this, the cyber criminal use the impersonation domain, and also they use the type of scouting technique. They spend the time into planning for launch this kind of attack. They use the account takeover technique, or they research the target organization to understand the business transaction, and then they will prepare for that. They will not randomly send any phishing email. And to execute this conversation hijacking, they use the impersonation technique or the type of scouting, as I mentioned, such as replacing one letter in legitimate URL with a similar letter. So instead of R, they will use N, that kind of thing, or adding an unnoticeable letter to a legitimate URL into the domain. And in preparation for the attack, they will register or buy the impersonation domain that from where they are sending in the email. So domain impersonation is remain the very high impact attack for the conversation hijacking. It can be very easy to miss the difference between this legitimate URL and into the impersonated URL. For an example, an attacker tried to impersonate, let's say, barracudanetworks.com, would use a similar URL like barracudanetwork.com instead of, they will not use S at the end. They might change the spelling to barracudanetworks.com and they might replace the A with double RA or something like that. It's very difficult to identify by the visual what we can see on the Outlook email or anywhere. And sometimes attacker change the top level domain. So last, instead of .com, they will use .net. That's what we have seen in the previous slides. Instead of .int, they use .org for the WHO and to fool the victim. And in addition to that, we are seeing that conversation hijacking. This is the attack which we have seen recently in few months that are very complex, difficult to set up. It requires a lot of time and money from the hacker as well. And what they do, they actually get into the account of the specific user by account takeover, and they will open the email information of the previously email that has been received, and then on top of that email they will just click the reply to all but with the impersonated domain. And imagine that you are getting the same subject name, same history of the email, and on top of that, if a hacker is asking you for the critical information, the user will, who does not have the knowledge of the this kind of attack, of course they will fall into the trap of this. And this is where it will become very difficult to identify this kind of attack. So here in the example, you can see that attacks are getting more sophisticated in conversation hijacking. It will reply to the existing conversation, and to and from, we have kept it right now blank because of the security reason. This is one of the email that we have gathered from one of our customer where we have identified the attack after being our product has been delivered, and we have kept it blank because of the security reason. What we have seen here, the email, it was reply to the existing conversation, so user have access to all the previous email that this specific user has received, and in same email it is asking to change the payment method and send it to the different account, and the person who is responsible to transfer the money thought that this email came from the higher authority, so he or she has to do it, and then they fall into the trap and lost millions of money. So as we see that there are different kind of advanced attacks being going on, and in situation where it's very critical to provide protection to all our customer, what are the best practice that we can offer to the customer? So one of the best practice remain the password cycling, where you can set the password policy to for each employee to use the strong password, and it is mandate to change the password frequently based on the policy. Second one is the secure login. Ensure that web mail application use the encryption, and this is the standard functionality, but again it's very critical. Then the spam filter, of course you have to use that spam filtering and the protection. Email encryption, you can use the email encryption technique for the critical employee of a company who has the authority to do the wire transfer, or who has the very sensitive information, you can enable the email encryption. So those customer who has the Barracuda product, it is already available. Email encryption, you don't require any extra licenses. You can use the email encryption out of box in the Barracuda. And lastly, but not the least, is the employee education. Engage employee in ongoing security education around email security risk, how to avoid falling into the victim's phishing attack over the email. Some companies send their own employee. You can do that. You can send the own employee the phishing email which is not harmful in order to test their resistance to this kind of attack, There are different tools available to provide the training to the user and to test their knowledge about the email security, where they will fall into the trap or not. So as we discussed, now we will move to the email threat product that I'm going to show you. So the traditional email security is not sufficient to provide this kind of attack, and what we are going to discuss is specifically about Office 365. So we have the API based security, and we have the integration with Office 365 directly, and that's why we can not only scan what are the email which is coming and going, we can scan the email internally, as well as we can scan the email which is already been there in the inbox of the user with our product called Barracuda Sentinel. So this is where it is very helpful for the end customer to provide the protection against all the advanced threat. That's what we have discussed. So this is what is from my side on the presentation. And most importantly, stay safe. And we are here for you and your customer to provide protection against the email threats. What I'm going to do is now I will end the presentation and show you the demo of email threat scanner and how easy it is for you to go to your customer and show them this demo that I'm going to show you. So this is the link, the scan.barracudanetwork.com. What you need to do, you need to create the account. Now, beauty of this product is to, you may be using the top security from any other vendor or the security that is available in the Office 365. You will not have to change anything in your existing setup. We have the API integration, so you just need to provide the your domain credential, and then we will be able to scan everything. And by the end of this scan process complete, we will be giving the full report with all the information that we have collected. So I have one demo account. So what I will do with that, I will log in into the Barracuda Threat Scanner. I will just provide the username and password. If you don't have the account, you can create the account as well. So I will just save the password. It will ask for basic information about your company name, demo, phone number. What is the country? United Arab Emirates. Continue. So connect to Office 365 for email threat scan. So it will generate a report on the past attack of your account. So be very specific to the customer that it will not going to give you the protection, this email threat scanner. It is only going to give you the reports of the past attack that already occur. And you must have the Office 365 global administrator account to authorize this. So I will connect to Office 365. And it will ask me for the specific information that Barracuda will require. So this is the information that our app will like to read on the specific, you know, maybe log data, directory data, the mailboxes, and you can accept it. So this is depend on the user that it wants to allow the read access to the all the data that is there on the Office 365. I will just accept it and then we are good to go. So generally we'll recommend to allow the of threat scanner or the Barracuda Sentinel to scan the traffic for at least 24 hours to 48 hours so that we can give you the report, and then it will scan everything into the Office 365 account. So this is again a demo account. I have only one email mailbox into this. But what I will show you is the reports or the demo account of the Sentinel that is already there. So as you can see, this kind of reports you will get. You will get the summary that how many fraudulent email is already there and information about this. So what is fraudulent email? The total number of fraudulent email detected in your account across all recipient during the scan. And please note, this information in the other section of report might display only one instant of each attack. So they will give you full, we will give you full information of each information that we there. And here you can see we have scanned 393 mailboxes. Domain fraud risk is 7. And if we go what kind of fraud that has occurred, so this is again one of the recipient. And from where we got an email and to where. So ECMAcop is the our domain, and this from this is where we got the email. And attack type is again employee impersonation. So this kind of attack we have detected. This is again after 24 hours to 48 hours. You can export this report to CSV and show it to customer that your existing solution is good enough or not. It will give you more information about that. The what kind of analysis that we have done. So you can see the from email address is not actual recipient that you can see on the email address. It communicates an urgent request. This email asks the recipient for her availability to respond to the specific request. So this is the analysis that we have done to identify that this is the impersonation attack. And more importantly, you can search for similar message as well by just clicking on that. So it will give you the full information related to that kind of email. That is Barracuda Forensic and Incident Response. It's a different product. So this is about impersonation, top domain at risk. So this is our own internal domain, which we have protected or which we have scanned from the threat scanner demo. And you can see that it can be spoofed and used to fraud. These are the information that we have gathered. Employee exposure. At risk employee is around 6.6%, and which is 26. Another employee, which are low risk employee, is, and these are the risk factor. So you can sort the risk level and identify which are the employee that you want to go and educate them to provide the specific information against the protection. Top recipient of fraudulent email, which email has received the top phishing email or the fraudulent email. So you can get that information. This is executive vice president. Again, this is just for the demo purpose. And if you click on more detail, you will get all the information about that email, that what has happened, into what kind of email was there. And you can even go and check specific email as well for the each user. So this will be really useful to show the demo to the customer. And here impersonation sender, which tried to impersonate themselves, its identity from actual identity. This is the data or the graph here. And top fraud sending domain from which you are getting the email. Popular subject used in the fraud is the payment request. This is the subject name of the each email which has been used in the fraud email. Request, urgent, you can see. And then again, you can search for that four email that you have generated. So these are the sender and these are the receiver which has actually request for the payment. And then you can see whether it has actually done or not, and you will get more information about email. And type of fraud, here you will get the graph about the attacks. Is there any conversation hijacking, impersonation, black email, service impersonation, and scamming? So these are all the information that you will get. And then you can show this demo to your customer that will give them the idea about where their security stand. And you can finally export the information into the CSV file, and again you can use it for the to increase our chances of the product to sell it to the customer. So this is what is all about from my side. Again, the link name is scan.barracudanetworks.com, where you can actually go and use the Office 365 account and do the scanning for your Office 365 account. Again, this is only for Office 365, not for any other. In the meantime, the demo which we have done, it has scanned the one email box that is again my admin domain only. As you can see, it has scanned that and there is no email. So this is what we can do. And after 24 hour or 48 hour, if the email is there, it will surely come here. So thank you very much. If you have any question, just let me know. I'm here to answer. You can type your question into the question and answer field and I will be happy to answer that. So that's it from my side. Bindiya, you can take it forward.
Hi, this is not Bindya. This is Mansi here. Thank you all for attending this session, and I'm looking forward to work with you guys. We'll drop you guys a thank you email as well. And if you guys have any queries, you can get in touch with me for the sales front, and get in touch with Ravi in terms of any pre-sales POCs required. Wherever we can help you and support you guys. So yeah, thank you so much, and looking forward for working together. Thank you.